Hello Steno Candidates, I am Ravina. Welcome to your own YouTube channel, Lotus Steno Legal Matters. I am going to dictate you Steno Legal Matters. Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for more dictations. So be ready for the dictation. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start. Both the appeals arise out of common order of principal judge, Family Court, Jhansi, dated 18 January 2016, passed in case number 205 of 2011, filed by the appellant Srimati Monica Gupta versus Jitendra Gandhi under section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act and case number 94 of 2011 Jitendra Gandhi versus Srimati Monica Gupta under section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act stop. Next para. Case number 205 of 2011 was filed by appellant Srimati Monica Gupta against the defendant oblique respondent under section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act for annulling marriage on 15 April 2011 before the principal judge, Family Court, Jhansi, case number 94 of 2011 was filed by respondent Jitendra Gandhi under section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act for restitution of conjugal rights before the court of additional senior civil judge at Gandhidham, Gujarat, stop. The said case was transferred to the court of principal judge, Family Court at Jhansi by orders of the Supreme Court of India dated 23 April 2012, passed on transfer petition civil number 166 of 2012 stop. Both the cases were tried together by the court below and was decided by common order stop. Plaintiff oblique appellant filed case number 205 of 2011 under section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act for annulling the marriage on the ground that she was married to the defendant oblique respondent on 12 December 2009 according to Hindu rites and customs at so and so district, Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh, stop. It was contended that when she was 7 years old, stop, both her parents died and she was brought up along with her two brothers by her maternal uncle and aunt, Musa and Mosi, stop. It is they who had performed the ceremony of Kanyadan and gave Dori as per their status, stop. It was contended that after marriage there was constant demand for Dori by the in-laws and appellant was not treated well, stop. For 3 weeks she stayed at her in-laws house and thereafter came to her maternal home along with her brother and after leaving for 15 days, she again went back to her in-laws house from where her husband took her to Gandhidham, Gujarat, stop. In paragraph number 5 of the plaint, it has been specifically stated that at Gandhidham, Gujarat, the respondent started pressurizing the appellant for sharing bed and having physical relation with his friends. On refusing to do so, she was beaten by her husband, stop. In paragraph 6 of the plaint, it is stated that appellant had intimated this to her in-laws, but they were not helpful and scolded her, saying wife has to obey her husband, stop. Next dictation. whether section 47 of the act is required to be read independent of the lexical clause in section 2 of the act, thereby distinguishing persons with disability from those acquiring disability ? Further still, does the disability as defined under section 2 of the act apply to the threshold appointments, while the acquisition of disability under section 47 takes into its fold all sorts of incapacitating instances of a serving employee independent of the lexical clause ? Compendiously viewed interpretatively, to what extent the legislative expression, unless the context otherwise requires, controls the definitions under section 2 of the act ? To unravel the controversy, we may refer to the facts of the extent required for the purpose. The petitioner, a widow with SSLC qualifications, having a visually challenged minor daughter, secured employment as a conductor in the last quarter of 2004 in the respondent corporation on compassionate grounds after the death of her husband in harness stop. After serving 3 years as conductor in line bus, when the petitioner developed hypertension and respiratory problems, on her request, the respondent corporation assigned to her light duty as ticket issuer stop. Though the petitioner had been continuing on light duty since 2006, when her request for a permanent posting as a ticket issuer was not considered, as she filed WP within bracket C number 29264/2010, which after certain interim directions, though exhibits P1 and P2, was eventually disposed of by this court. Though exhibit P3, judgment dated 25 February 2011, directing the respondent corporation to take a decision on changing the petitioner's category on the basis of the recommendation to be made by the medical board stop. Though the petitioner produced exhibit P5, medical certificate issued by the medical board that the petitioner is not suitable for strenuous work, the respondent corporation issued exhibit P7, order dated 23 September 2013, directing the petitioner to resume her regular duty as conductor stop. When exhibit P8, representation dated 25 September 2013, did not yield any result, the petitioner filed WP within bracket C number 24769/2013, questioning exhibit P7 order. In fact, this court, though exhibit P9 judgment dated 11 October 2013, directed the corporation to consider the request of the petitioner in terms of section 47 of the act, apart from directing the corporation to allow the petitioner to discharge light duty till then stop, in compliance with exhibit P9 judgment of this court. The respondent corporation issued exhibit P11, order dated 3 April 2014, rejecting the claim of the petitioner stop. Later, the second respondent issued exhibit P11 within bracket A, consequential order initiating insisting on the petitioners resuming her regular duties stopped.